getting paid to freestyle. Different cities every week now. Every woman is now. With state prop, you looking bleak now. I was home to sleep designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true, cause you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I brung it up. Wait.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
Well, Coach, no precipitation to speak of, but still a very chilly December day in Philly. Winter coats and hot chocolate abound here at Lincoln Financial Field. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New Orleans Saints and the Philadelphia Eagles. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line.
Here we go, here we go.
Number 53, Mike 53.
Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. And from the 25, they worked this to the 29, a gain of 4.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. To throw, it's Wentz. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. 6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4.
I'm going back to you. I'm going back to you.
Check 13. Check 13.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. Following the delay, here's 2nd and 9.
53, Mike 53.
Hey, check, check.
Now Wentz. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and he's got daylight. It's a foot race. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up 2nd and goal. From the 2 now, 2nd and goal. They'll try and push it in with Gurley. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up 3rd down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels. Because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Noah Fant, his second touchdown on the season, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Lutz with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Credit the sack to Malik Jefferson. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's 2nd and 20. Throwing now is Wentz. Gets this to his running back, Jordan Howard. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Now Wentz on third down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. That'd be ideal.
12 yards there, good for a Saints first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. On first down, it's Gurley. Uses the stiff arm. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And he takes it across the 50 to the 46-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now it's Gurley. So he got free of one tackle but couldn't do a whole lot else. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line. On the toss, it's Gurley. He's got the first down inside the 10, and he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Todd Gurley with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year, and the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Lutz good on the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. 2 drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky?
He's got a convoy and he might be gone. The 20, 10, touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, 77 yards as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. They were already down two scores early. They needed something to try to stem that tide, and that certainly qualifies. A big play to get them in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed, because let's face it, they don't get something done on this drive, turn it back over, this game could be 88 and out the gate early.
What? 88 and out the gate?
Yeah.
What's that?
Well, listen, I used to hear my old man talk about it. Usually meant that thing's done.
Well, now that they got the touchdown, it's not 88 and out the gate. We still got a good game going ahead of us. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
It was Josh Sweat who got him down on the defensive side.
A gain of two brings up second and eight at the 37-yard line.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up.
Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Throwing on second and eight, Prescott. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 17 there and a New Orleans first down. First down, Prescott. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. He lost 9 there. That's really going to set him back for second down. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Now Prescott, airing it out deep for Smith. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Prescott yet again. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
And I feel like my man, Old Mo, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a three and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their own 14-yard line. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and 4 and second and 8 and 9.
On second down at 4, Wentz. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Cameron Jordan in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Right here, guys. Mike 51. No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. But when this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off at the 18. And they'll have a short field to work with inside the 15 at the 13-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carry.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Todd Gurley with his 14th touchdown of the year, 2nd of the game. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Lutz with the extra point, and it's now 21-7. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. Aguilar has it. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down. On first down, they run with Howard. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Wentz on the give to Sanders. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. This is Howard on second down. A gain of two there on the heels of a one-yard pickup on first.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Hey, here we go.
Right here, guys.
From the gun, it's Wentz. And that will be incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted, but I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Yeah,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason.
First and 10, Prescott. And that'll be incomplete. He was trying to find Noah Fant, the tight end. And that'll bring up second down.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
To throw again on second down, Prescott. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Prescott from the gun. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
They'll run on first down. It's Sanders. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
On second and 7, Wentz. That's complete to Arcega-Whiteside. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. On first down, it's Sanders. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. It's a second down run with Sanders. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Miles Sanders, as the first half is winding down, as his guys are back within a single score. Well, this could be a big turnaround. They get the touchdown here in the final moments of the second quarter. And remember, Charles, they're going to get the ball to start quarter number 3 as well.
So what you're saying is if they take the ball down to start the second half and score again, it could change the entire complexion of this game, couldn't it?
Absolutely. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something that feels somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go 4 verticals, because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to 2nd and 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits from these creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield. He's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
On 3rd down, it's Prescott. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down. So no problems moving the ball in the first half, but they'll likely come up empty here on drive 1 of quarter 3.
And it was so important for the defense to get that stop, because what we witnessed in the first half was them getting run over. And they needed the confidence, and they needed to get off the field, so they felt good going forward in this game.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And he makes it all the way down to the 31. A huge play there on the screen pass. 51 yards. And an Eagles first down.
So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. They'll run on first down. It's Sanders. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Another run with Sanders. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. On first down, Sanders. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. It's been an excellent day for him running the football, no doubt, as he continues to soar well past 100 yards.
Yeah, it almost feels like he can just grab his briefcase and head home after putting in a full day's work at the office, doesn't it?
Go, go. Go, Tony!
On first and goal, Howard. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. They'll try again with Howard. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. 6 plays got him down here. This is play number 7, third and goal.
He's scared.
Check. Goal.
They'll try to run with Sanders, and he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown run, and the Eagles have taken the lead. He's got the hat trick now of rushing touchdowns, also has his team the advantage.
And I'm looking at it two ways here. If I'm on defense, I don't care what they do now. I commit as many people as it takes to slowing him down running the football. Even if they want to hit me over the top on play action, I just don't let him beat me that way anymore. And if I'm him, I'm in the huddle calling the plays myself. I don't care what play call comes in. I tell my quarterback, guess what? You're handing it to me again.
And if I'm the quarterback, I'm saying, okay, that sounds good, right?
Smart quarterback.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL,
pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost
Well, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Fletcher Cox in there to get him, and that is now sack number 18 on the season for him. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Mike's 50.
Back near his goal line, it's Prescott. And they're going to sack him yet again. The pass rush has been relentless. This time, it yields a safety.
And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Ooh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points.
Wentz and the Eagles now with a 1st and 10 right at the 30. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia.
It's the Eagles in possession of the football and leading this one as we get ready to start the final quarter. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now this time, Wentz will throw. His throw incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
Shotgun now for Wentz. And he finds Howard complete. And he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. He'll have the win at his back here in the fourth quarter.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them.
T.Y. Hilton, nobody to beat. Past the 20, 10, 5. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 75 yards. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. On first and goal, Gurley. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. A line of scrimmage once again, the 5, as they get ready for second and goal. And he fires one incomplete. T.Y. Hilton, the intended receiver. But now it's third and goal.
See, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch as the arm there, the leg's still there. This has been a tough game. And now the third down throw incomplete as well. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
Now Prescott on fourth down. And no, it's incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And this Eagle defense stands tall down near the goal line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense forced the turnover on downs. They've got the lead. They're in good shape, but can't go into a shell here, right? Still got to be careful.
Yeah, because they're still a long way away from kneel down time. So they've got to work on getting first downs, keep the sticks moving, right? Keep the clock going. And above all, ball security. Don't turn it over. At the 6-yard line.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll go again with Sanders. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be third and 10 now. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Bang, 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 bang.
Go, 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 great, great.
53's Mike. Check, 53's Mike.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home, yo. Let's make these babies cry all the way back home.
Check 99! Check 99!
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Push him back. Push him back.
Mike, 53. 53.
Hey, wahoo!
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Open man, Arcega Whiteside. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on third down, and he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a first down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one.
I smell fear in that offense.
Tighten up, tighten up, tighten up.
The Eagles will take their third and final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. This is fielded at the 27. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And last time they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
A simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Here's Prescott. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Give him 18 there, and the Saints have a first down.
And the Saints first down.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Complete. Smith has it. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now on second down, this is Gurley. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, third and 1.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. Figuring they're going for it on fourth down. Remember, though, they do have all three timeouts, so even if they don't get it, all is not lost.
Yeah, normally in this situation, when you're talking about having to go for it, everything is in this play. But as you noted, with those three timeouts, they actually have a little bit of a safety net.
And down by 5, they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
Here we go. Here we go.
Prescott to throw on fourth. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Eagles defense able to hold. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
The last run got 3. Now here's second and 7. Another run here with Sanders. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
The 20!
Check 53 is Mike. Hey, watch the screen, watch the screen. Watch the screen.
On third down, they turn to Sanders. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really...
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to come up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
There we go. Back, back. Waiting.
Check back, check back.
Wait, touch.
The Eagles in the victory formation as they take an E.
A loss of a yard brings up second and 11 at the 46-yard line.
Here we go, here we go.
Number 53, Mike 53.
Let's go, let's get this ball.
Wentz with a kneel down, and that will be the final act of this game.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So it's a victory here for the Philadelphia Eagles. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for Philadelphia, they remain in the hunt for a first-round bye as they move to 11-3 on the year. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the San Francisco 49ers. Meanwhile, for the Saints, they drop their 10th game now to fall to 4-10. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis.
Mexican dummy pesos. Get you some